Ko Karioi te maunga, ko Whangaroa te awa, ko Irani, Irish te iwi, ko Piripiri, tako whānau, ko Cheryl Reynolds, e hau. Kia ora tātou, I'm Cheryl Reynolds, and I have the sheer delight in living in Whangaroa, Raglan, and I've been here for 15 years. I'm an artist, a philanthropist, and an entrepreneur, a bit of a serial entrepreneur. And I am just here with the Edmund Hillary Fellowship as a fellow looking to develop my 12th startup, which is called 3Cs, a working title for conscious creative content. The purpose of it is to license creative content to urgently fund the change that we need in the world, including everything that we've just heard for Papatūānuku. There's no more urgency for the future of Alina's child and all of the children, all of the children to come, but also to fund the inequities on our planet of injustice around poverty and women and girls. So if you're interested in that, please come and talk to me. Well, I'm not going to talk about that now. I'm going to talk about a very personal story. And I'm going to talk about the power of hidden stories. So, and I'm going to do that by just setting the scene and then through three tweets, share with you a personal journey. And leave it there. So, setting the scene in the philanthropic world that I've been in. My 11th startup was a philanthropic foundation called Momentum Waikato, beautiful foundation. The philanthropic sector, much like the Edmund Hillary Fellowship, is very sharing, caring, open. And we come together as many foundations to share and learn together. And at one stage, a year ago, I was in a room with trustees and my fellow leaders in the philanthropic space. And there was this one trustee who wasn't like us, who was talking about homelessness and talking about how anyone who is homeless has brought it on themselves. It's their own fault. It's their own circumstances. They've created their own world. And inside, I was screaming. But I didn't have the words to say anything because I had a hidden story, which is that I was once homeless. And I wanted to say to her, you're talking about me. Now, my story is one of having been brought up in London in an Irish pub and beautiful parents who unfortunately lost their business, went bankrupt. The pub was our home. We lost our home. My father got ill. He died. And then my mother, with her mental health challenges, and I, as a teenager, ended up in a homeless shelter, and where we stayed for 9 months and until we got ourselves sorted. And I learnt resilience. I learnt the personal capacity that I didn't know that I had for coping. And we all have such great resilience. So moving forward, that's my story. There's a tweet. These are my three tweets. So the first one started with a Tesla in Hamilton, Kirikiriro. My first Tesla I saw, and I tweeted it, and a guy from an energy company who knows me said, oh, we have a whole suite of e-cars. Come and drive one. And so we went for a drive. And in that journey, he told me and Kiwis in the room will remember the Pacifica teacher, the woman who was on a breathing machine, and because she lived in poverty, was unable to pay a bill, and her breathing machine was turned off, and she died 3 hours later. When he told me that, I then shared with him my story of, as my father was dying, we couldn't afford to pay the bills, our power was turned off, and what it was like to live in London in a a house with no power, wrapping my dad with blankets and working to help him in candlelight. And he was quite shocked. So that enabled me to start to tell the depth of my story to my partner, my friends, my family. And then we had that conversation a week before I went to Canada to a conference. And at the end of the conference, I got a Greyhound bus over to Montreal to meet my mother on Mother's Day. And because I'd had that conversation in the car the week before, it enabled my mother and I to have the most important conversation about her hidden stories. And it was a powerful coming together. And I won't go into that, that's her story. But my mother, in having that conversation, I said, can I share our story? And she said yes, because she thought it would help people. So I am here with her permission. And then Sid Waikato, Gemma is in the room, a co-founder, invited me to come and speak. It's a youth movement in Kerikeroa, in the Waikato. And this was the first time I spoke publicly and told my story. And in telling the story, afterwards, one of the other speakers came up to me and said, there's a girl here, she's 16 years old. Her mother died, her father's thrown her out. She's homeless, she's living on the street or on couches. And will you meet her, will you talk to her? And I did, of course. And what I realized is that in sharing my story, in her situation, I was able to give her hope. So I invite you, if you have a hidden story, to think about the power of it and to think about sharing it and giving others hope. Thank you.